Esau sells his birthright. Abraham's son Isaac married Rebekah, and they had twin boys. The first twin was named Esau. Esau grew up to be a hunter. He became his dad's favorite son. The second twin was named Jacob. Jacob became his mother's favorite son because he liked to stay near home. The order in which the twins were born was very important in those days. The twin born first, Esau, had the birthright. This meant that near the end of Isaac's life, Isaac would give most of his land, money, and possessions to Esau because Esau owned the birthright. Isaac would also give Esau an extra special blessing. In Isaac's family, the blessing on the firstborn son was even more important than the land, money, and possessions. Since Jacob was secondborn, he wanted to get Esau's birthright, so he was always on the lookout for an opportunity to do so. One day, when Jacob was making some stew, Esau stumbled up to him looking for food. He had been out hunting and was weak from walking through the fields. "Quick, give me some of that stew," he demanded. Knowing his brother needed food right then, Jacob said, "If you give me your birthright, then I will give you some of my stew." Esau felt like he was about to die. He said, "What good will my birthright be to me if I die?" That is what Jacob wanted to hear. To make sure he would actually get Esau's birthright, he made Esau swear that the birthright was now his. Esau did. He said, "I swear that my birthright now belongs to you. Now give me some of that stew." Jacob was glad to serve his brother now that he owned the birthright. Isaac eventually grew old and neared the end of his life. Not knowing that Esau had sold his birthright to Jacob, he called Esau to his bedside and said, "Esau, I'm getting old. I'd like to give you my special blessing, but first go out and kill an animal and prepare for me one of your special meals." So Esau left to hunt and prepare a meal for his father. Isaac's wife Rebekah secretly listened to Isaac's instructions to Esau. After Esau left to hunt, she told Jacob to pretend to be Esau and go before Isaac to get his blessing before Esau returned. Jacob took two of their young goats and brought them to Rebekah. She cooked them just the way Isaac liked and gave the meat to Jacob to take before Isaac. Jacob said, I don't know about this, mother. Esau isn't like me. He's hairy and smells like the outdoors. If father knows I've tricked him, he'll bring a curse on me instead of a blessing." "If that happens, I'll take the curse upon myself," said Rebekah. "Just put on some of Esau's smelly clothes and put this goat skin on your hands and neck. Isaac will never know the difference. He is too blind to see who is standing before him." Jacob put on the goatskins and Esau's clothes, and with his mom's cooking, went in to see his dad. "Who is it?" said Isaac. "It's me, your firstborn son, Esau. I've got dinner, just like you asked." "Esau, is that really you?" asked Isaac. "How did you kill this food so quickly?" "It's really me, Esau," Jacob lied. "God showed me favor when I was hunting. Now please eat this meal and grant me your blessing." "Wait just a minute," said Isaac. "Come a little closer." Jacob leaned in closer to Isaac. "Your voice sounds like Jacob," said Isaac. "But your hands feel like Esau." So Isaac ate the meal Rebekah had prepared for him. Afterwards, he asked Jacob to come even closer and kiss him. When he did, Isaac could smell Esau's clothes that Jacob was wearing. With that, Isaac put his hands on Jacob and he gave him his blessing. After receiving Isaac's blessing, Jacob left quickly. A short time later, Esau came into Isaac's tent and said, "Here I am, Dad. I've got your meal prepared, just like you want it." "What? You're Esau?" said Isaac, trembling. "Then who was it that just served me a meal? I have already blessed him, and I cannot take away the blessing." Esau and Isaac were both upset that Esau had missed out on the blessing, but there was nothing Isaac could do. The blessing now belonged to Jacob. God did choose to bless Jacob instead of Esau, but the way Jacob went about getting Isaac's blessing was wrong. God wants us to treat others with love and respect, and trust Him to work out His will for our lives.